What's up, guys? I'm GrimNinja, and we're here with another video of Mafia 3. We just took down the smack racket and gave it to Cassandra, and now we are on our way over to talk to her. I'm almost completely out of bullets, and they conveniently left a boat here for us, so we might as well take it. Right there. It's perfect. Perfect boat driving. There we go. He wouldn't get up for a second there. Don't hit me! Ah! I made you stop. Alright. And here we are. At the place. I'm gonna get stuck on a pole. Okay, stairs, right here. I've located the stairs.
Who sets dead, the hollow's yours.
They say you strung him up on the old Ferris wheel.
He killed Ellis. Shit all over the people in this neighborhood. Doucette got what he deserved.
The righteous will rejoice when he sees the vengeance. He will bathe his feet in the blood of the wicked. That goes both ways, you know.
Thought you said all that was behind us.
My men are struggling with the notion that we now have to answer to the same men who killed Baca, who wiped out half our number.
If I was them, I'd get over it. Time to go around coddling people.
Of course not. But gestures carry weight. And if you were to help my man, Emmanuel, that's a gesture that would go a long way in calming nerves.
What's he need?
He oversees my reefer operation over at the boathouse. Help him, and I'll see to it you get a potion of the profits.
Just so we're clear, I'm expecting a cut of everything, not just what comes from selling weed. It's gonna cost a lot of money to take down Marcano.
Don't worry. I'll make sure you get your money.
You're about to assign this district to Cassandra. Each underboss wants to improve their urn, so they'll offer you favors like weapons, markers, vehicle upgrades, and services through their associates. Sorry guys, I feel like I'm about to sneeze. Marker, expenses for your next call to Cassandra's associates will be covered. Thank you. Rackets in current district 2. So now we get... Oh, we don't get that until we get 100,000. Okay. Go ahead and assign that to Cassandra then. Optional mission unlocked. Talk to Emmanuel. Whoa. Sorry guys, that was my game. Not my recording. How do I get out of here? Oh, right here. Okay. Use markers to pay for associates. Okay. Go ahead and call in the arms dealer.
I'll head your way now.
There he is. Coming in hot. Stopping in the middle of the street.
See anything you need? Show me what you got.
Yeah, show me what you got. Okay, apparently I can use the money that's in the safe to buy weapons. Cool. I really want a rifle. I like that, Hartman that I had. $7,500, though. Maywood 30. The Viper 55 looks cool. Automatic weapons. The trench is what I have. I'm not going to waste any of my money yet. I'm just going to refill my ammo for the guns that I have. And we'll spend an additional 6 shot. Why not, right? Just to make sure we have at least one.
Call me if you need me.
I will. Thank you. Hop in this car here. Okay. We have optional chapters and story chapters. Let's go ahead and talk to Emmanuel, or whatever his name was.
Breaking news in New Bordeaux. There are reports of a violent shootout at the abandoned Baron Saturday's
farm. I'm not hitting anything.
The authorities haven't released an official tally, but sources are reporting multiple casualties. One witness claims to have seen a man hanging from the very top of the decommissioned Ferris wheel. The police have refused to comment on the veracity of that report. The fun park has been closed for a number of years and was once a subject of controversy for what colored civil rights groups described as racially inflammatory imagery.
Now, I don't know how they figured out about the guy hanging from the Ferris wheel so fast, because I just did it. Haven't really gone very far since I've done it, but I don't know. Maybe people heard gunfire and, you know, snuck in right as we left and called the cops, and they got there in like, you know, 2 minutes. Let's go ahead and get down here. Just take a swim. And talk to Emmanuel. Looking at that boat pool.
You want to buy something? You need to talk to Cassandra.
She said you could use some help. Assuming you're Emmanuel.
Assume at your own risk, Lincoln Clay.
So running the weed, y'all got a routine laid out?
We take a boat to the bayou, grab the bears, bring them back.
Bayou can be a rough territory. Dixie Mafia knows every inch.
Do those white boys scare you, friend? Did they touch your zozo when you were a child?
Andra Fair mentioned your charming personality.
I highly doubt she forgot.
You do this kind of thing back in Haiti?
Back in my country, I was a hoogan, a priest.
What does a priest know about trafficking weed?
I did not run marijuana, Frey. My cargo was refugees, people. I saved their lives, got them away from Duvalier. But you probably don't know much about that.
We gonna have a problem, you and me?
Cassandra says we are partners, that everything is cool between us.
Don't think of that.
Neither would I. Cassandra might be able to let go of what you did to our people, but I cannot.
Maybe you'd be happier back in Haiti.
It was not my choice to come here, leave my home. But, trying to make the best of it.
Aren't we all?
There are still Dixie Mafia scattered around the hollow. If you have the time, you should see to them. Convince them to leave.
Trafficking's an optional way to increase an underboss's earn. That allows them to pass along more to you. Complete traffic runs also uncovers more about your underboss's lieutenants and increases your underboss's loyalty. Make deliveries to rackets to increase their earning potential. You can continue to go after Marcano's organization or complete trafficking runs to fatten your wallet.
A shipment of weed is being delivered down in the bayou. Get a boat, use it to bring it.
Okay. And for the record, nobody touched my Zozo when I was a child. Not that I know of. The weapons locker over here is just ammo, though. Which I shouldn't need any of. But, you know. Alright, cool. Just making sure.
We're cleaning this place up right, thanks to
you. You're welcome. See, they like me. I don't know why that guy doesn't like me. Before we go anywhere, we're gonna make a stop here to grab some adrenaline, and then we're gonna make a stop over here to grab a tech vest. Almost said flak jacket, but no, a tech vest. Okay. Let's set a waypoint here. Take the weed airdrop and deliver it to a friendly bracket. Go to the smuggling dock. Wow. Yeah, that's kind of far. And I don't really want to make that drive yet. I will at some point in time, don't worry. But for now, we're going to go talk to Donovan. Making their own alcohol. Yeah, some, if you know how to do it. Oh, that's not true. Know how to do it. Some, I've passed the location. I need to stop talking whenever I drive. if you know how to do it, or you know someone who does it, some homemade moonshine is actually pretty good. Really strong. At least the guy I know that does it makes it really strong. But it's not too bad. It really gets you if you drink too much of it, but it's not bad. What up, Donovan?
Come on.
Ooh. Wrong. Angry.
This goddamn thing keeps jamming up. If you're ready to start it.
Show me what you managed to dig up.
You got it. Two of the city's finest scumbags.
Wait, what did I pick? What happened?
The man himself, Mr. Vito Scaletta.
You gotta be shitting me.
Last couple months have been pretty tough on old Vito. Sal's always hated him. Thought he was a mole for the commission, but he couldn't do anything about it because Vito's maid. After the heist, Sal refused to pay Vito his cut. And then he's been trying to limit his ability to pay what's owed.
And if Scaletta can't kick up, the commissioner gave Marcano permission to whack him.
The only reason that Vito is still above ground is because he has a couple off-the-record businesses. He's been using that money to pay Sal.
Gotta give Scaletta credit. Pretty goddamn tenacious.
He's lasted a lot longer than I thought he would, but the clock is ticking. A couple weeks ago, Sal sent in his nephew, a kid named Michael Greco, to help Vito run River Row. Greco's been using his guys to limit what Vito can do, where he can go. Once he has Vito completely boxed in, he'll make his move.
Scaletta has to know what Greco has planned. I'll pay him a visit. See if I can leverage this thing with Greco to bring Scaletta to thinking.
I'm sure I'll be concerned.
Okay, and the other guy.
Oh, yes. Point for Dunn's favorite son, Thomas Burke.
How's he doing since Danny?
9 weeks ago, Burke stumbles into Roman the Butcher Barbieri's deli, drunk off his ass, waving a gun around. He fires off 10 rounds, but the only thing he manages to hit is a fucking ham hock in the goddamn deli case. The butcher's boys slap the shit out of him and toss him in a dumpster.
Barbieri's the one who took over Point Verdun, right? Busted up Burke's leg with a tire iron.
That's why Burke was willing to go along with the robbery. He thought he'd make things square with Sal, and he went back.
He always struck me as an asshole.
Yeah, just like every other Irishman. But he hates Marcano as much as you do.
Yeah, all right. Least I can do is give Danny's old man a chance for a little payback. Oh, fucking hell.
He's been spending his time in a dive bar up in Point Verdun. Duffy's, it's called. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
Yo, you better be worth all this trouble.
Okay, Thomas Burke and Vito Scaletta.
How Having the people down here.
I want a veto skill. I don't care about that other guy. The blade stained red. Okay. Talk to Burke or head to Vito's. Let's go ahead and head to Vito's. Yeah. He's pretty far. Okay. I don't really know how the wiretapping works. I don't know if I can just do it at any location. Or if I need to... Whoa. Wow. I messed that car up. Just sitting in the car as if he didn't even flip. Does it say where I can wiretap this area? No, I might have to activate it by talking to Vito first. Cop across the way there, so... Okay. At least the cop didn't see that. I didn't do anything, I promise. Whoa. Whoa. Okay. So is he gonna be surrounded by...
Word about how it's going in there.
How do you think? Vito's taking his beating. Plus Greco would just let us kill him, post some bitch and get it over with.
Nah. Greco wants to show how
I need to get out.
Beat on old Vito until we all respect him.
Okay.
If only all it took was beating up on a washed up carver bagger.
Huh?
You didn't see anything.
You see that?
No. There was nothing to see. Why would he see anything? Okay, the other guy's not coming over. Oh, there we go. There we go. You need to come back over here. Hey, he's whistling too. I wonder why it's so odd whenever I whistle. The guy needs to turn around.
Nothing.
There we go.
You and me ain't getting paid. Want that car? About right, Walt.
You know what I mean. Look, I get doing them coons over in Hollywood. Hell, bringing that little crackle Richie in.
Be quiet.
A Vito's made.
Was made. Word come down from on high that Scaletta's out, and that means he's out. Anyway, Greco might be stupid. He might even be crazy. But right now, he's the one calling the shots.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you. You don't want to do that. I don't know how he didn't see me. But I'm glad he didn't. Grab this. Can't go through those doors, I guess.
There he is!
Nope. No, he's not. I'm just not good at the stealth. I don't understand. Oh, he got off his thing. I wasn't expecting him to just get off of his thing. His forklift. It's not a thing, it's a forklift. I'm sorry. I'm not so... Maybe a little bit. Okay. What's in here? On the outside. Oh, that's the junction box. Okay, they're just looking that way. I should be able to... Wait.
Not a goddamn peep now.
Stay behind me!
Huh? Uh-oh.
What?
There we go. Okay, I think we're okay now. Oh, it takes three.
Well, Greg go around, ain't no one feeling real secure about that place, so we just keep at it.
It takes three in order to wiretap. It's good to know. I can't get through that guy. Huh? Okay, well, I can do that. I didn't think that would work from that far. Come on.
What was that?
There you go. Get down. Take out the cook. Ooh. What's that? Yeah, I don't need that. Ooh, what's this? That's a Vargas painting. I don't know. It looked like a safe at first. How am I supposed to get those guys? I know how I can get one of them, maybe. Huh? Yep. Uh-oh. Okay, no, it's just one. Now, the other one needs to stop looking.
Huh?
I knew he saw it.
Shit. Fuck him.
I got it. Okay. I don't think anybody heard me, really. Oh, you can only have three of those.
Not a sign of them.
And there's one over there.
Only so many places to hide, partner. Take him down. Oh.
There we go. What's going on out? Oh, Vito's in there. I'm here to save you, Vito.
You scared little fuck! Keep it, you little pigeon! My morning shit is tougher than any dream! Dancing there! Break my...
It's okay, Vito. It's okay.
Looks like I got here just in time, Vito.
Lincoln. How's this possible? I thought you were dead.
The bullet was deflected by my skull. Came out the back.
Look about them luck.
Worst place to shoot a fella's in the forehead. Skull's harder than you think. Come on. We need to have a talk.
When I heard about what happened, I went to Marcano asking my cut right then and there. I figured if he fucked you and Sammy, I'd be next.
Yeah, I'm guessing he didn't go for it.
Said he wanted to wait for the heat to die down. Didn't want me running around, buying expensive shit, getting noticed. Like I'm some fucking amateur, never sat on a big score before. The money I fronted for the robbery was pretty much everything I put away. Didn't have enough to run, so I stayed. The commission wouldn't let him just kill me, so I figure I'd make that cocksucker jump through every hoop. Make him prove I deserve to get one. It wasn't much, but it was something.
Pretty bad his nephew to push you out.
A kid named Michael Greco. Nephew by marriage, not blood.
Sure didn't number in here.
Yeah. They were looking to see what other rackets I was running. Like I'd leave a fucking paper trail in my office. Eh, don't bother with that shit. Look, appreciate you getting me out of the freezer and all, but, what are you doing here?
Marcano deserves to pay for what he did, so I'm going after him. Him, his brothers, his lieutenants, all of them. And I'm gonna need your help.
Look, pretty much whittled me down to nothing. I mean, this is it.
For now, maybe. But once I take back River Road from Greco, money will start coming in, it'll be a different story.
Also, we're partners now.
As long as you do what I say and give me what I want when I want.
So goodbye, Marcano, hello, Lincoln Clay.
It's either that or more of this. And next time, I won't be around to fish your ass out the freezer.
Nobody kills that scumbag. You bring me Greco. I'm in.
Tell me about his rackets.
He took over the dock union, and he's got a warehouse. He has a lot of valuable shit in there. You take both of them out. Greco's finished. A couple of my guys been keeping tabs on him. You should talk to them. They'll fill you in.
All right.
I got it. There was something. Oh, you can call the other. We partners now. Vito agreed to help you kill Marcano. Okay. To come pick up and store your extra cash so it's not lost if you're killed in action. Plus, once upgraded, it will collect any available for you for Carter. Now, there was a collectible. Can I not climb over? I guess not. Vito doesn't want me climbing over his bar. Is there something in here? I don't know. Must be the Vargas painting that's up here. But I can't get... Oh, now I can. Okay.
Hey, Lincoln. I could use a little more territory. Look, just some room to grow, you know?
Yeah, no, man. I understand. I get you what you need. Don't you worry. I will take care of you. Now. Contraband. Union extortion. DeMarco is tied with Vito and will do anything to get him back on top. Jock's reluctant to trust you. Jock. I don't know who that is. But his loyalty to the working men of the docks leave him no choice. Okay. That's down there. That's up there. This is way up there. We're not going to do that yet. Guess we'll do this because it's right here. But we're going to do that in the next video. Thank you guys for liking, comment, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.